right, your boy 171. Yeah, about to get it in on Resident Evil Village. Was trying to get it in Resident Evil Verse. They don't even have the damn game ready yet. Now, that was a kick in the teeth right there. So, gotta go with the standby, secondary, I guess. But, that being said, let's go Village. But nah, that was foul though, the way he did that. Damn, you all hyped up. I got the game thinking, I got a good deal of Resident Evil 8. And they got the Resident Evil Verse right there in the sidelines. And I'm ready to play. And it says the game's not ready. Come back later. And then I hear all this stuff about 2022. I'm like, all right, 2022 is less than a couple of days away, but really? That'd be some hot shit if they make that for New Year's or something like that. That'd be hot. If they open that up for New Year's for people to play, yeah, I'm there. I'm there. Believe that. I'm most definitely there. Oh well, guess you don't want my day to. Would you like to watch a recap of the Resident Evil 7 Biohazard story? Recommended for those who have not played Resident Evil 7 Biohazard. Alright, humor me, because I never played that shit.
Okay, where to start? My name? It's Ethan. Ethan Winters. It's been 3 years since everything happened at the Baker House. I was looking for my wife, who disappeared. I got an email from her. She told me to come get her. And of course, that's how I ended up in the middle of nowhere, Louisiana. I found Mia being held captive in a dark basement. She wasn't thinking right. She attacked me like some kind of wild animal. Later on, I found out that she was infected by a special kind of mold. I looked all over the house trying to find an antidote, a vaccine, anything. People who lived there were already infected. What was left of them wasn't human. The source of the infection was a bioweapon that looked like a little girl. Her name was Evelyn. I fought the fucked up family and was able to treat Mia's symptoms with a serum. Then Chris Redfield and his soldier buddies showed up and saved the both of us. Is that enough? I really don't want to talk about what happened anymore. It's all over now.
Or at least he thinks it's over. Yep. Alright, Resident Evil Village. I played this several months back in a demo, and I was digging the demo. But I wasn't digging the price for the game itself at the time. But, you gotta love discounts, I'll tell you that. So, let's go. Let's see what they got for bonuses. bonus, really. Well, would have been nice if the data that I had from the demo would still be on there for me to actually obtain as, you know, movies and stuff. But whatever. Let's see what they have for this in the PlayStation store, just to see. Some giveaways and goodies, huh? Let's start with something simple. The Survival Resources Pack. $1, I guess it can't hurt. Let's start normal, just because it's... Wait a minute, so the settings is... Game settings. Oh, okay. Game display, okay. So the game settings itself is different from the regular game settings itself, or whatever. The game play settings or whatever, I don't know, whatever. You would think it'll be normal. You think the game settings itself for the game would be over here too, besides I guess this is just the controller settings, that tutorial. Display tutorials, gamers display, agent HUD and all that. I would assume that's gameplay settings. Game settings. Not this game settings. Difficulty. Yeah, I ain't gonna front. Lightweight first. Just saying. So I can get used to the game itself.
Long ago, a young girl went with her mother to pick berries for her father, who was hard at work. But the forest greeted them with a dark, cold silence, the bushes empty. Yet determined to find the berries, the rascal broke free from mother's grasp and vanished into the trees. Mother's worried cries faded fast as the girl ran on, over vine and under branch, and into the forest deep. Feeling strange eyes upon her, the girl recalled mother's scary bedtime tales, and her throat became bone dry. Then the Bat Lord appeared. He greeted her warmly and bit his own wing. "Come, child, quench your thirst," he said. So she drank the thick, dark blood and smiled with joy. Passing through the graveyard, menacing storm clouds loomed, and the air turned bitingly cold. The girl was shivering in her thin clothes. Then a dark weaver appeared, and with a click of his fingers, crafted mist into a beautiful dress. "Come, child, warm yourself," he coaxed. So she clothed herself and smiled with joy. Across waters deep and ominous she went, hoping a boat she found would carry her home. But hunger's grip tightened and her heart grew heavy. Then the Fish King appeared and offered one of his many fins. "Come, child, eat your fill." So the girl ate and smiled with joy once more. Continuing on, she soon entered the forest's dark heart. Then an iron steed appeared, bearing a beautiful golden gear. The creature said nothing as the girl approached and snatched what she thought was another gift. The horse grew angry and summoned the other monsters. Terror filled the girl's heart as the wild wind rose around the beasts. Suddenly, a witch appeared, dark, yet regal. "Gifts we gave, but more you took," she snarled. "So more in turn is due." In a blink, the girl was trapped inside a mirror. There. She's asleep.
What is with the creepy story? She's only 6 months old.
Woman at the store said it was traditional. A local tale. Besides, Rose doesn't seem to mind.
Because she doesn't understand it, thank God. We moved here so that she wouldn't have to deal with any of that, remember?
There's nothing wrong with my memory.
You're just being paranoid.
It's not... Never mind. I'm sorry. But I'm not paranoid. I'm just cautious.
Then, go cautiously take your daughter to bed. I'll finish dinner.
It's okay, Rose. Your mother doesn't want to remember it. I can't blame her.
Did you say something?
Nothing. I'll put her down. Once you're a big girl, we'll have a drink together, all right? Our taste in music's definitely improved over the years.
You mean mine has.
Once things warm up, we can go for a walk. There, there. It's like I said to your mom. That book's too scary for you. Gotta do a deep clean before Rose starts walking around. Everyone's forgotten about this already. Almost there, honey. I wish it could stay like this forever. Can't keep your mother waiting. She's scary when she's angry. There you go, sweetheart. Don't you worry. I'll be right downstairs. Daddy won't let those weird fairy tale monsters get you.
Thing I didn't really dig about this game is the first person look. I don't mind the third person. First person is alright, but I like the...
Is she okay?
Sleeping like like a baby. That smells good. What's that?
Oh, hands off, mister. It's churba de legume. It's a local recipe.
Wow, you've gone full native, haven't you?
Local wine, too. But if you're gonna keep sulking all evening, maybe you shouldn't have any. You really have to stop worrying.
It's just finding you in Louisiana, the pregnancy, Chris moving us here, military training, it all happened so fast, you know?
Well, at least we're all together. You, me, Rose. Now, everything's gonna
Seriously, think we can just forget about what happened in Louisiana?
It happened so long ago. I don't understand why you are so...
Mia! Get down! Mia! Oh, God. Chris? What the hell?
Sorry, Ethan.
No! What? Why?
Go on, move!
All clear.
Rose? What the hell are you doing with my daughter?
Package secure, sir.
Take him away.
I said get your hands off her!
Ethan, no.
Hey, Doc.
Hello, Mr. Winters. I've got your daughter's results back, and I'd like you to come in to talk about them. How about next Thursday, 4 o'clock?
No problem. We'll be there. That was the doc. She'll see us next week. Hey, now. Think positively, all right? We talked about this.
I know. We hardly talk about anything else. I keep telling you, it's not Rose that I'm worried about.
Well, then what are you worried about? Look, she's gonna be fine. I just know it. What else matters?
We matter, Ethan! You matter! You just won't.
Mia, what are you talking about? Is there something you're not telling me? Come on, talk to me. Damn it. I have to take this.
Yeah, the plot thickens and gets kind of weird for me to understand right away.
Jesus.
About damn time. What's your status? Is the package safe?
What are you talking about? Where's Chris Redfield? And Rose?
Who is this? This is a secure channel. You are not walking out of the portal.
Fuck. What the hell happened here?
Now the next question I got was, I've been real Chris Redfield or not? Person or whatever. Funny how they got Resident Evil verse in third person, but they ain't even got the damn game ready yet.
Huh.
guess I'm on the right way now. Ain't no way to close that door, huh? Looks like a file over there, but it doesn't look that important since he can't grab it.
nowhere else to go back but up.
What did all this?
Well, it would have been nice if something was in that drawer.
Where the hell am I? Maybe they're out.
Maybe he's out of his mind. They're gone. Oh my goodness.
Thank you.
feature. That's right. Took a minute because you don't need that word feature somewhere.
What happened?
Did they just run out of the house?
Okay.
Shit!
Find a way out. Oh. There it is. Those are curtains.
No! Friendly! Friendly!
Who are you? Who sent you?
Nobody. There was an accident down on the road and... What's going on?
Oh, no. They're coming.
Who is? What the hell was that?
Do you have a gun?
What?
Please tell me you have a gun.
No, why would I?
Take it! Take it!
Tell me what's out there. Are you listening?
Hey!
What the?
Shit! Dead body? Wait, there's more.
It's that old dude.
Jesus Christ. What the hell is wrong with this place? What the hell?
It says his health is fine, but he just lost a couple of fingers. Okay.
Thank you.
I know where to go with that one. If I'm supposed to use that now.
Is it over?
I don't know.
Hello. If there are any survivors out there, come to my... to Louisa's house near the fields.
Survivors?
Thank you.
back. Oh, wow. This is where I just was. Oops.
Okay. There's no end to them.
Oh, crap. Man, this dude is really having a bad day.
Wait.
So, do they have a save point? Let's see, restart options. Nope, no save point. I wonder if it automatically.
In life and in death, we give glory.
Hello? You shouldn't be out here. It's not safe. What the hell? Hey, can you hear me?
It's you. The child's father.
Child? Hey, wait. Do you mean Rose? Is she here?
Rose! Rose, yes. She is in great danger. Since Mother Miranda brought her to the village, we have fallen into darkness.
What are you talking about? The monsters?
The castle bell heralds danger. They're coming!
No. Wait. Where's Rose? Who's Mother Miranda?
The bell tolls for us all. They're coming again!
Rose is here?
So this is where I started on the demo. So I think this part can get a little bit easier. Somewhat. Well, if I had a lockpick, that would get a little bit easier. Okay, so those are the places I've already explored, I guess. face plates I gotta find.
Guess this leads to the castle.
This is closed, though. I just would have been here and done that. Yes, I did. Find the other. Memory surgery, right? Here comes the not so fun part. Yep. Board it up. Freaking time. Oh my goodness. Huh, mines, huh? That could have played well. Alright, so my objective was to find that other piece. Hopefully I won't have no more monsters to deal with. Well, I got problems. Over here. In the grass, and you back up. Alright, so almost SOL. I know this is the way to go in between the grass to find this one key I'm looking for.
It's okay. I'm not gonna hurt you. I'm just glad to see normal people at last. Have you seen any other survivors?
No. They're all in Louise's house. And she's not answering and the gate is locked.
Quiet, girl. He's an outsider.
Oh. Shit, we're sitting ducks in here. Can your old man walk?
No. One of the monsters cut him. He's lost a lot of blood. We have to get into Louise's house.
Shh, quiet. Must be a way inside. Stay here. Be quiet. Don't move until I get those gates open.
Yeah, that's right. You gotta climb up here. Jump up here. Business in here. We go to the door to try to get the people to open up, but there's something over here he gotta get. We gotta have a key for it. And I believe that is one of the items that he needs to open up out of the main door.
Come on, it's clear.
Hurry, hurry.
Took your damn time. Oh,
you're welcome.
He's not used to relying on other people. I'm sorry. We'll be safe in here, won't we?
Safer here than out there, that's for sure. Hey, do you know anything about what's going on around here?
It doesn't make any sense. Mother Miranda has always protected us.
Nobody's answer.
Father?
Help me.
We have to get inside.
Just hold on a bit longer, Papa.
Hello? Anybody home?
Maybe a familiar voice. Louisa! Open up! It's me, Elena!
Stop shouting. You'll draw the monsters.
Julian, calm down.
Who's this?
A friend.
Stay back.
Father, for God's sake, Julian, let us in.
No, they'll smell the blood. You'll endanger us all.
My father will die out here.
But that's not my problem.
What's going on?
These people want to let a dying man into our home.
Come now, these people are our friends. Go on, go inside. Come now, this way. You're not from this village.
No. I'm Ethan.
Julian, go make yourself useful and check the grounds. I said go! Well, if Elena trusts you, then so do I. Come inside, Ethan. Wait here. I'll check on the others.
Gotta love the hospitality. Now this is what I remember in the demo. Turn the pages.
This way. Come inside. The others are waiting.
What the fuck is this? Outsiders, you're gonna get us all killed.
Quiet. Anton. He helped Leonardo and Elena.
We were doing fine by ourselves.
Please, Ethan. Take a seat.
Is this all that's left? From your entire village?
All that's left? All that's left? There is no one left! A worthless invalid! A stupid, wailing bitch! And you! You drag a bloody man and an outsider in here like it's nothing? And expect to be all safe? There is no safe! Every sorry bastard out there has been ripped in half! But tomorrow? Tomorrow we'll all be dead. Just like her damn husband. Put a sock in it, Roxanna!
That's enough! This house has protected my family for generations. And drunk or not, you are all welcome and safe in here.
Whatever.
Can someone please tell me what the hell is going on here?
We don't know. One day we were a quiet, devout village, and the next, the monsters came and attacked us. And they kept coming.
Wait, Louisa. Where is your husband? Did they...
No. No, he is out there. Somewhere. He went to get help. Yes, that's it. He went to fetch help.
There's so much denial.
Let us pray. For him. For all of us.
Good idea. Come. Gather.
Great ones, hear our voice. Together as one in reverence, we call on thee within the endless dark to deliver us into fate's hands. As the midnight moon rises on black wings, so we make our sacrifice and await the light at the end. In life and in death, we give you glory. Mother Miranda!
Now, the tea should be ready. Come help me, Elena, please.
That prayer, I've heard it before. There was an old woman near the graveyard.
You mean the hag? Dumb bitch is crazy as a bag of rats.
There is wisdom in her devotion, though. And I hope it protected her as it shall protect us.
What are you doing?
Leonardo, what's wrong? Are you okay?
Father!
Elena, no, stay back!
No, let me go!
We have to go! Father anymore. You did the right thing. Elena, no. There's nothing you can do.
Papa!
This entire place is collapsing. You couldn't save him. He was already gone.
Leave me alone.
No, we're getting out of here. Together. I gotta get out of here.
Wow. We gotta find the keys. To the truck. Oh, so the actual truck key is not the truck key. The screwdriver is the truck key. All right. Ooh, I'll take that.
Damn, the fire's moving fast.
What are you thinking?
Step back. We can bust out with this. Let me back up again.
The fire. There isn't any time.
Nowhere to go but up. Grab on. Hurry. Let's move. Don't worry. And try not to breathe in the smoke.
I know. Thank you, Ethan. You're kind. I hope your family is safe.
I do too. Once we get out of here, maybe you'll get to meet them.
That'd be good.
Come on, it'll hold. There, that's our way out.
Thank God. But what then? The village is still full of monsters. We can't fight them. There's too many.
Hey. Hey, don't talk like that. We'll find a safe house to put you in until I can find my daughter. My hunch is she's in that old castle.
No. That place is full of nothing but blood and death. And I don't want to be alone while you're... Father?
Elena, no. That's not him. Not anymore.
He said my name. Father!
Wait, it's not safe! Stay there! Come on, give me your hand!
Ethan, go! Save your daughter!
Elena, don't give up! Reach for me! Damn it! Why is everyone dying on me? This is just too much.
That's too much. Wow.
I just... don't get it.
A Resident Evil 6 movie. Somewhat.
This place is going mad. Why the fuck is this happening again? Shit!
Stop! Mother Miranda!
Hey!
Who was... What was that?
Trying to figure out if there was something in the ground after she dropped that dude, did they leave something in the ground for Ethan to look for? Nope, guess not.
Dead! Visited them all.
Yeah, she's a creepy one. You got nothing to say though? She whatever.
Nothing but blood and death. Huh?
Yeah, he's losing it. Uh-oh. He's kind of losing it. Alright, this is the part where he saves and tries to just get his mind together somewhat. Yeah. And this is where I stop. And I come back